So we all know that the HTML forms are created to collect the user data. So now we are creating a form here. So this is just a sample of a form which I am showing you here. This one, the sample form. Now I will be creating a form here with the help of this form tag. Now let's start. Before starting, I will be showing you the page which I have created before. So this one is a page. So if you want to create the page like this, you can check my previous video. After that, I will be writing here my form, creating my new form here. Okay. Okay. I'm making things a bit small so you can see clearly. Okay, now I'll be creating here, starting the form type or form element which you will be for. From inside this form, first I'll create the labels for my form. The labels will be, my first label will be, as I have created an employee table, now I'll be creating an employee registration form. So for that, first I'll create the employee name for what we are creating. Alright, here, employee name. And now we copy this and insert it in these places. For text field, we are using input type, what kind of text we are entering here. Text. And for authentication, we are adding here ID attribute, extra working which we are entering here, and also the name. Okay. So I will save this and I will be showing the changes in my page here. You will be seeing here the changes. Okay, so this one is page and this one is created. You can see the employee name has been created here. So after that, I will be testing this data and making some changes for the employee password and also the employee ID. So just say copy and I'll paste here. Before that, I will use here a create tag so it will not be in confusion for you. Things have been created. Now you can see here what is the output: employee name, employee ID, and employee password. So we have to create another break tag to make look it better. So I'll be using here another break tag, and here too. Break tag, and here another break tag. Okay. So now we are creating the break tag for creating submit button. So I will show you how to create buttons here. Very, it is very simple. Down now. Okay. Good alignment is also required. And now save. So we have some spaces. Okay. Things are looking very good. Now we are also, you can use here submit button. For a submit button, we have to write here the button element. Can you use here button element for creating the submit button? Here. Inside this, the button is always equal if we use this button type or any type of thing like button type, button click me or anything else. Now we'll be inserting here the text which will be the submit. Okay, break tags. I'll create another break tag. Now we'll be seeing here. Okay. So here the submit button has been created. You can see down here. Submit button. If I click on the submit button, it will be redirected to the same page. If we have to redirect to another page, so we have to use here server side scripting, which is like JavaScript, .NET or ASP3, which can store your data. So for storing data, we can also use for action like thing here for representing your data to another page or this thing. You can use here inside this form tag, we can use action attribute here. Action attribute inside this, I'll be writing the slash action underscore page dot php. This page will show error because we are not using perfect website or perfect server side scripting. So now I'll be just saving and refreshing here. Now if I something enter into this thing and here go. You can see if I click on submit button, it will be redirecting to some other page here. So the page is not found because you have not have any backend thing. So now after that, we can also use the radio buttons to set the individual thing. So for that, we can also create a reset button with this type of button thing. We can also have the many input types here. You can see I have copied some input types details here. You can use this hidden number, password, range, reset, submit, tell, text, time, text, which we are using now, submit we have used, and email which we will be using our next videos, button checkboxes we will be using now, and radio we will be using now, reset we will be doing later. So now first I will be using here the radio buttons. For the radio buttons I will be just input type. After that I will copy the labels and here paste, and inside input I will write here radio, okay. And inside this ID I will be writing here mail, and the name also will be, name will be here gender. Okay, now value attribute will be main here. I'll be closing this, and I'll be coming the label and also making the changes down here. So here the label, and do the label for here too, and inside this, okay, label I will only copy label and just paste it down here. And for we are adding here gender, and inside this we are adding mail, and say, and you can see the one radio button has been created with the name, with a radio button of male. We can also create a male, female, and others now will creating all this. So I'll be just copying and using the grid tags. Now we'll be seeing the differences in my page. You can see the three things have been created, male, female, and you can select this one individually. The radio buttons are used to select individually. So I will be using here another break tag to look things much better here. Another break tag. Okay. So things are looking much better here, male, female, and others. We can also select here caption for your form. So for the caption of your form will be using here caption element. Here after the form I will be writing here caption. Before caption I want to write this thing in strong. So inside this strong I will write in here caption. The caption I will be writing here employee registration form. Okay. Employee registration form, and this one should break down here. Save, and you can see the difference. The caption has been created, employee registration form. So I needed here another break tag. We copy and refresh here. So the entire registration form is this. We can also use here checkboxes. For the checkboxes, we have to just change the name of the radio buttons to the checkbox here. So I'll be copying this type of radio button things, radio buttons. Okay, over from here, radio, copy. And here I'll be creating some break tags to make things much better. Another break tag, and here I'll be copying this and changing things to checkbox here. And here for the checkbox, and here we have the checkbox. I'll be changing this to experience. And right here 3 years. And here to the experience, and here, and we're changing this one experience. Okay, experience, and here also 3 years, 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, experiences. Okay, adding the experience. Okay, and now here also I'll be adding ID will be the 2 years, and this one with the experience, and here the value will be the 2 years. Okay, now we'll go into the first one, which will be the gender, will be the age, will be the experience, and value will be the 0 to 1 years. Value will also be the 0 to 1 year, and here to the 0 to 1. Replacing gender with experience here. Let's see. Now you can see the checkboxes have been applied to my page. So here the checkbox you can select all. For the ready buttons you can select only the single things. And if I click on submit, it will be redirected to the next page, which is empty because we don't have your backend. Now here we will also be learning about the what is the get, what is the goal. So I'm already copying down this from the web, so you can easily understand with this text. So we can generally say that if we want to get some data from the server, we'll be using the get option. If we want to upload some things, we'll be using the post option, post it to the net. So get is not secure, because if you are using this get option, all the data, all the labels which we have written will be displaying on the web. First I'll be showing you this. I have used already in my tabs here. So here you can see, here we can apply this with a method, method option, actual.php here. I'll be using here method dot get. You will be seeing if we apply this get, all the labels which I have created, employee name, ID, all the things you can display over here. First I'll refresh and back to the previous page. Now you can see if I enter some data here, already it is visible. You can make this user with the help of JavaScript, CSS, and this. Now I'll be teaching about the basic things, right? So I'll be continuing what I'm doing now. So I'll submit here. You can see here the employee name, employee ID, employee other things, parts, password is just visible here. Hackers can crack easily all these things. So if we use here method is equal to post, no one will be able to see what labels which we have used here, and no one will be able to crack easily. So I'm going back to the previous page and refresh these things, and I'll write this again, some data, random data here, and password I'm inserting the mail here, anything which can select. I'll select all this one, checkboxes you can select all, and submit. You can see the only .php is visible, not our entire label is visible.